What's up everyone and welcome back. As you read from the title, today we are going to look at an ARGB heatsink I recently purchased for another PC, which is a Ryzen 3600 based. As you saw from the videos in my channel, the last air cooler anyway that I used for my personal PC was around in 2010, so I am with the liquid cooling since then. Anyway, what we are going to review today I think will be a great option for all of you who are looking to replace the stock AMD or Intel cooler without having to damage your wallet too much. I was in fact able to get this heatsink we are reviewing today on Amazon for just 40 bucks, but I saw also in some other shops selling it around $35 or even less, which I think it's a great deal for what we get. We are talking about the Deepcool GAMMAXX GT A-RGB heatsink. Wow, long name for heatsink. Anyway, after the release about 3 years ago of the Deepcool GAMMAXX GT, a bit less than a year ago, Deepcool revised this design for a brand new cooler. That's why today we are going to look at its successor, so the GAMMAXX GT ARGB. While offering multiple aesthetics and performance tweaks, the main difference is really that the Deepcool GAMMAXX GT now can be purchased with ARGB compatible lighting effects. Talking about the main differences, we see first of all that the fan is now a PWM design with an improved speed of 1650 RPM based on the 1500 RPM of the original one. Then also the top section of the cooler has been redesigned in order to show the Deepcool logo. It also has a nice matte black finish. The lighting system can now be controlled via the motherboard or by using an included wire connector. We also have new copper pipes that improve the heat transfer and dissipation efficiency. Also, the new fin mounting process elevates the ventilation, and then the mounting kit which makes this heatsink really easier to install. With its height of around 158 mm, it's big but not too much, so it will fit most mid-tower cases. And as we can read from the manual, we have multiple CPU and sockets supported, so compatibility won't be an issue. Talking about the fan specification, we have a fan speed of between 500 and 1650 RPM, as we said. The fan airflow on the other side is 64.5 CFM, and we also have a very good fan noise, which is less than 28 decibel. In case you need two, you can also obviously purchase an additional fan and install it in a push-pull configuration. But now let's proceed with a quick unboxing, then I will show you how to install it, and finally we will be ready for some benchmarks and we will see how it performs at high workloads and looking at the overall temperature. So follow me. And here the box. At the back of it, we can read all the specs and see all the other models of the series. After opening it, we find the plastic bag with everything we will need for the installation on Intel or AMD platforms. Then we see the usual installation guide, which is a single sheet of paper. And here the cooler. As we can see, it's pretty big. We have this new design on top. And we can see the fan blades are transparent in order to enhance the light diffusion of the ARGB LEDs. We are now ready for the installation. I'll be mounting this on a Ryzen 3600, but the kit also includes everything you need for the installation with Intel CPUs. We need to make sure we use the proper holes depending on if we are mounting it on AM4 CPU or an Intel one. After opening our case, I will start removing the old heatsink. In my case, you see I'm using the stock cooler that comes with the Ryzen 3600, so the Wraith Stealth. Once removed it, I will quickly clean the CPU and remove all the pre-applied thermal paste. We are then ready to install the new backplate provided with the cooler. Then you can see here in my hand the insulation gaskets and the screws we need to apply for fixing the backplate to the motherboard. I will now remove the fan from the heatsink in order to have more space for the installation process on the CPU. When removing the protection from the base of the heatsink, we can see the new fins. As from Deepcool, the new fin mounting process should ensure smoother ventilation and a more efficient heat dissipation. I won't be using the thermal compound provided in the kit, but will use my own Noctua Anti-H1 paste. As usual, we have several preferences on how to spread the thermal paste on the CPU, but based on my past experience and tests, I prefer to go for the X method, trying not to put too much on it. Then we can install the heatsink by using the two provided mounting tools and one screw on each side for securing them. What is left now is just to screw the four spring screws, proceeding in diagonal order as usual. Once everything is secured in place, we can proceed reattaching our fan with the provided clip. I will put this oriented in this way so that the airflow will be taken by the fan at the back of the case and will push it outside. Then we just have to connect the fan connector and the ARGB connector to the motherboard. If your motherboard has no 3-pin 5V ARGB support, you can use the provided controller. Now I'll quickly check if everything works as desired, and then we'll group a little bit the cables in order to hide them. Anyway, we can now see how well the diffusion light works on the fan. But what I really like is the lighting of the Deepcool logo at the top of the heatsink. Now we can have a look at how the temperatures of our Ryzen 3600 look like before and after the installation. In 3D Mark FireStrike, we can see a degrees of 12 degrees Celsius when looking at the minimum temperature recorded. While if we focus on the max temperature reached during the benchmark, we have a stunning difference of 32 degrees by using the GAMMAXX GT A-RGB heatsink compared to the AMD stock solution. We therefore go from 105.4 degrees down to just 73.3 degrees, which is a much more acceptable value. The fan wasn't even loud during the max workload. Then looking at Cinebench R23, we get confirmation of what we already observed during FireStrike. The difference in temperature compared to the stock cooler is huge. And even more evident now with the difference of 33 degrees in the highest temperature and 13 degrees for the minimum temperature. We can also see a slight increase in the Cinebench score compared to the AMD stock cooler. So as we see, this is a great alternative to the AMD Wraith Stealth, which is the stock cooler I have on the 3600X, and it's even better than the Intel stock coolers. It will also obviously perform better than the other AMD coolers, such as for example the Wraith Spire. Also, it will outperform a very famous and common heatsink like the Coolmaster Hyper 212 EVO, and will perform very similarly to the Noctua NHD15S. So in the end, for 35 or 40 bucks, we can't really complain with this product, and I would suggest this as an option to everyone who is looking to get better temperatures than the stock coolers. And also appreciate the RGB lighting as a plus. Since the temperatures are much better than the stock cooler, you can also think about a basic overclock without causing excessive overheating or thermal throttling. Then let me know in comments below what you think about this product and about this video. Anyway, I am currently working at the review of the Toshiba N300 4TB version, so if you are interested in that, hit the like and subscribe button for getting notified, and feel free also to check the other videos from my channel for more interesting content. But anyway, that's all I have for you today, so we will see you in the next one.